Hi guys, this video is about the fan inside of VY, VZ, VX. Common problem with these fans is that sometimes they stop working on low, second level, third level, fourth level, and they only work on high. In order to repair it, there are certain steps which you have to take. But first of all, the tools which you will need for the job. Obviously, the PH2 Phillips, long nose pliers, a bit of tape, ducting tape or electrical tape, a bit of soldering iron itself, and the solder, if it works the way I just mentioned to you, only on high, and a little bit of your time. First step, we have to open the glove box and remove the limiters. Limiters for the glove box, for this moving compartment, located on both sides. This is the rubber which stops it in position. On most of the vehicles it's already worn out or ripped. So by pulling the bottom of it from inside out and down, you can remove that limiter. Exactly the same you have to do on the other side. Pull it out, pull it down, and it's out. Once you've done that, you can pull the whole glove compartment out of the housing. So it's quite easily done. Just don't hesitate. That's the way it's done. Now here we can see the cause of the problem. This is blower motor resistor, and that's the one which controls the speeds on your fan. In order to proceed with the job, we have to remove this few screws, and for that we will need a screwdriver and PH2 head. One of the first things I would suggest you to do, do not try to pull it out the way it is. You'll be spending quite a bit of your time trying to figure out how to pull it out. It's just waste of the time. Instead, undo the screws which are holding the crossbar. Right, it's quite quick. Right, that's one. After that, we're removing the other one, which is holding the side panel. And number three, which is here. Once the screw is removed, you can see how easily the side panel of the dashboard or the control panel comes off, and you will see two mounting screws on here for the crossbar, which will limit the movements of that resistor. So for that purpose, these two screws on the side have to be taken out. That's first. Not quite there, and the second. Okay. Now, as you can see, crossbar here is easy to move, and we've got access to the two screws which holding the resistor. Before you remove it, I would suggest you to unplug it. So by pressing the little lever on the top and pulling it out, you're disconnecting this resistor. So I've disconnected the resistor. Would be good to move it out of your way. Using the same screwdriver in PH2, you undo the two screws, one on top and one on the bottom. Don't lose these screws. These screws are different to the other ones. Put them aside separately. And as you can see, I can easily pull it out. Because crossbar is no longer on my way and it's free to move. This is the cause of the problem. In most of the cases, that resistor, if your fan works on high, has got blown link here. I'll just show it to you that's it, it's better focused. It's blown. So what happens, that link comes off. And all you have to do just to resolder it. If your fan doesn't work on high, you might need to change the whole blower motor resistor. And that's how it looks. The cost of this blower motor resistor from Holden is $125. Now, the job itself doesn't take a lot. What you do, you use your soldering iron and resolder it. Now, do it carefully, because that springs back. That's why you need to use long nose pliers. Once you resolder it, you insert the resistor back in position. And when you're doing that, make sure that the arrow, which is right here, I don't know if you guys will be able to see that, there's an arrow. This arrow on that side, I'm trying to get a bit of better picture. Yeah, this is the arrow here, right there. It's supposed to be facing to the rear of the vehicle. So that's the way it goes in. You're inserting it back once you fixed it. Pull the metal bar a little bit down, right? And push your resistor back in its position. Right, that's how it's done. Now, we're doing reverse, everything in reverse now. Couple of screws on top and bottom. Right, that's the top one. A new screwdriver with PH2. To secure it in position, don't do it too tight, because the bottom hole is not lined up. And the second one, which is going to the bottom. Again, you see, because the bar is loose, I can bring it down a little bit. Once I've got these two screws tightened, don't over tighten it, because it's plastic at the back of the screws, and you might just stuff the thread. Bring the connector back in position. And push it inside. Okay, now it's connected. Before you start assembly, I would recommend you to run your fan to check if it works. For that purpose, we start the engine and we check the fan. I can see I can feel it's blowing already on level 1. If I'll go to level 2, it's blowing. Level 3, level 4. Turn your engine off, and the complete reassembly of what we've done before. Well, I hope it's gonna be quick and easy for you guys. You will save yourself more than $200 doing it yourself or repairing it. Otherwise, if you're not happy with that, you can go to the mechanic. Now, don't forget that the Titanic was built by professionals, but the Noah's Ark was built by amateurs. Don't be afraid. It's a simple job, straightforward. There's nothing sophisticated about this. If your resistor is completely blown out, in that scenario, you have to buy it from Holden. Unfortunately, they're not readily available because the vehicle's 10 years old or older, and it has to be pre-booked with the Holden, so they can bring it from the stock from the main bases in Adelaide. Good luck with that, guys.